submit to the name of the Lord in the highest.
Come and drink from this fountain.
To the name of the Lord in the highest. You are welcome to the program The Living Waters on Etrem TV. My name is Olakunle Beloved Jesu Kale, and today we are looking at something very deep and something very special. And I would like you to get your Bible, get your pen, and get a jotter, so that because the Lord is about to speak to you. Today we are looking at serving God in ignorance. Serving God in ignorance. You may want to ask, that is it possible for somebody to be serving God in ignorance? You may want to ask, that is it possible for somebody to be serving God, but his service to God is categorized and is seen by God to be ignorance? Yes, it's very, very possible. Let us look at the book of Romans chapter 10 from verse 1. This was a desire, a outcry of this apostle. He was interceding in prayer. In the book of Romans chapter 10 from verse 1, he said, my heart desire, brethren, and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved. For I bear them record that they have a zeal of God, but not according to knowledge. For they, being ignorant of God's righteousness, are going about to establish their own righteousness, and have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of God. Here we see the category of people who are going about that establishing their own righteousness. This category of people are going about preaching self-righteousness, depending on self-righteousness, thinking that they are serving God. This category of people may be in the church. All what these people do is that they are serving God in ignorance. This man was praying for their salvation, because if you are serving God in ignorance, you are not saved. You are serving God in ignorance. You think that you are saved, but you are not saved. This is a serious matter. There are people like that in the church in this end time, where they are workers in the church, they are believers in the church, they are pastors, and they may own a ministry, they may run ministries, but they are serving God in ignorance. This is what we must understand. Because God is not the author of confusion, and is not going to accept any service that is done in ignorance. In fact, in the book of Matthew chapter 23, we see that Jesus Christ rebuked the Pharisees for their persistent ignorance. And so God is saying that those who will serve him, we need to serve him in truth. We need to serve him in spirit and not in ignorance. Let's look at the book of Acts. Let's see another man who was serving God in ignorance. This is a serious matter that we need to understand here. The book of Acts. Look at the book of Acts, chapter 10. Let's see from verse 1. Acts chapter 10 from verse 1. There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italia band, a devout man, and one that feared God with all his house, which gave much alms to people and prayed to God always. He saw in a vision evidently about the ninth hour of the day an angel of God coming to him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, what is it, Lord? And he said unto him, that prayers and alms have come for a memorial before God. And now send men to Joppa and call for one Simon, whose surname is Peter. Here we see clearly that Cornelius was a religious man. This man can fast and pray. This man always give alms, giving. But I am surprised that heaven's declaration of this man was still that he was serving God in ignorance. He had to be led and directed to go and meet Peter, so that he can show him the way of service. The way of service that is acceptable to God. The way of service that God is going to accept. He was busy fasting and praying, giving alms. In his own understanding, he felt that he was serving God. He felt that if you can fast and pray, if you can give, then that means he's serving God. The category of people like this, as in the church today, these people are fasting and praying. They will declare so and so fasting and praying in some churches. They will declare so and so fasting and praying in some churches to defeat some battles. They will come there. They will say that they want to serve God. They will say that they are serving God. Some of these people can give. If they are the first person that will give in the church, they are the first. But These people feel that as they are fasting and praying and they are giving, it means that they are serving God. This is not correct. You cannot be serving God in ignorance. If you are not saved, God is not interested in your offering. If you are not saved, God is not interested in anything that you are offering to him. You may be a pastor, a worker in your church. If you are offering services and you are not saved, you have not encountered God, all what you are doing is that you are serving God in ignorance. Even Isaiah cried against the ignorance of these people who were just serving God in ignorance, and God cried against it. Look at the book of Isaiah. He cried against their ignorance. Isaiah, look at it. Chapter 58 from verse 1. Cry aloud, spare not, lift up thy voice like a trumpet, and show my people their transgression, and the house of Jacob their sins. Yet they seek me daily, and delight to know my ways, as a nation that did righteousness, and forsook not the ordinance of their God. They ask of me the ordinance of justice, and they take delight in approaching to God. Wherefore have we fasted and said they, and thou seest not? Wherefore have we afflicted ourselves, and thou takest knowledge? Behold, in the day of your fast, ye find pleasure and exact all the labors. Look at verse 5. Is this such a father have chosen, a day for a man to afflict his soul? Is it to bow down his head as a borage, and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him? Without God is a fast and an acceptable day to the Lord. These people, when God cried and lamented about their religious characteristics, their religious lifestyle, they were still serving God in ignorance. God is asking them, am I asking all this fasting from you? You are just wasting your time. Am I asking all this? What about all this iniquity that you have refused to put away? What about all this self-righteousness in your life? I'm not interested in this self-righteousness. Who is asking this kind of fasting from you? God is also saying the same thing about this generation. This generation can declare, we are going on the 30 days fasting and prayer. We are going on the 7 days fasting and prayer. But these people have omitted righteousness. They have omitted purity. And they have omitted the grace of God in their life. In the book of Matthew chapter 23. Come and see again. People who were serving God in ignorance. Look at Matthew 23. From verse 23. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites. For ye pay tithe of mint and anise and cumin, and have omitted the weightier matters of the law. Imagine. These people also claim that they are serving God, but they have omitted the weightier matters of the law. Look at what he said. What are the weightier matters of the law? Judgment, mercy, and faith. This ought ye to have done, and not to leave the order undone. The category of these Pharisees and Pharisees are just interested in tithe, offering, in collecting offering, collecting tithe, collecting all, following all sorts of rules that will bring them money. Can you see that this kind of thing too is happening to this generation, where our pastors have become prophet of Belial? They have become bad prophet. They have become prophet that are prophesying for money. They have become prophet who have become prophet that are greedy of their own and covetous. They are greedy and covetous, and they are blind spiritually. They are so blind spiritually because they have omitted the weightier matters of the law, and so they are leading the people in ignorance. They are serving God in ignorance, and they are leading people to hell in ignorance. Look at what he says, that they have omitted the weightier matters of the law, the essential things of the kingdom, the most important things of the kingdom has been neglected today. If you neglect the most important things of the kingdom, which is righteousness, holiness, judgment, mercy, if you neglect restitution, and you neglect proper submission unto Jesus Christ, following Jesus Christ, discipleship, if you neglect it, and what you are just concerned is about fasting and prayer, is about giving, is about getting breakthrough, you have omitted the weightier matters of the Lord, and you are serving God in ignorance. In rebuke that. Say, look at you. You have omitted the weightier matters of the law, judgment, mercy, and faith. Imagine, this generation have neglected the faith as of old. They have neglected that kind of faith to serve God, the faith to wait on God, the faith to be ready for his coming, that faith that brings the total change in people's life, the faith that makes people to repent and serve God. They have neglected it, and what they are concerned about is about giving, is about giving, is about offering, is about bring this, is about bring that. This is a serious matter. God is saying that you cannot serve me in ignorance. If you omit the weightier matters of the law, you are not serving me in ignorance, and I'm not going to accept that. If you look again In that same place, in the verse, look at what it says again. Look at in verse 25. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye make clean the outside of the cup and of the platter, but within they are full of extortion and excess. That is, you are so self-righteous that you are considering external righteousness. You are considering that you are clean outside, but you did not take care of your inward man. Look at what this generation, they are so concerned about actual righteousness, giving, make the don't put on this, don't wear this, but they have neglected the inward righteousness. They have neglected total brokenness. They have neglected manifesting the fruit of the Spirit. They have neglected manifesting the character of Jesus. You may even wear long skirt. You may wear long skirt. You will remove your earring and your mobile attachment. But as long as you have omitted the weightier matters that God is asking from you, as long as you have omitted it, you have omitted that inward man, you are serving God in ignorance. You are serving God in ignorance. This is a very, very short matter here. It is a very, very short matter. Look at verse 28. It says, even so ye also outwardly appear righteous unto men, but within ye are full of hypocrisy and iniquity. Can you see that? He said, you are full of hypocrisy. You are an iniquity. So imagine the category of so-called believers, so-called Christians, who are full of hypocrisy and iniquity, and they are claiming that they are serving God when they have not removed their hypocrisy. This is serving God in ignorance. Look at Jesus also told Jesus, look at that same Isaiah again. Look at that same Isaiah. Look at the book of Isaiah, chapter 1. Isaiah cried against the religious activities, the self-righteousness, hypocrisy, the ignorance of these people. Look at the book of Isaiah from chapter 1. See what it says. Look at what it says from verse. Let's look at from verse 11. He said, to what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices unto me, said the Lord? I am full of the burnt offerings of rams and the fat of fed beasts, and I delight not in the blood of bullocks. He said, I'm tired of all your sacrifices. You are always busy doing worship concert. So this generation, they are busy with worship concert, this concert, that concert. When are you going to call repentance concert? When are you going to call the concert of heaven? When are you going to gather solemn gathering and tell people about the righteousness, about the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ? When are you going to preach the truth to the truth of God to people? Why are you just after the useless things that matters, that does not matter to the kingdom of God? He said, bring no more vain oblation unto me. I am tired. All these things are abomination unto me. Look at what he said. And when you spread forth your hand, I will hide my eyes from you. Can you see? And when you make many prayers, I will not hear. This is why it is not good to serve God in ignorance. It is not good to serve God in ignorance, because on the last day, you'll be surprised that you have been serving him in ignorance. Look at the book of John. This woman also was serving God in ignorance. Jesus had to teach her and say, stop all these religious activities. Religious activities. You are just doing religious activities here. You are ignorant about Jesus Christ. You are ignorant about God. You are just doing religious activities. There is no true conversion. You, this woman, you have to repent. Look at what he told him. Look at what he told this woman. John chapter 5. John chapter 4. See what he told the woman. He says that in verse 21, look at, let's start from verse 19. The woman said unto him, sir, I perceive thou art the prophet. Our fathers worship in this mountain, and ye say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. Jesus said unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when ye shall neither in this mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. You worship what you know not. We know, but we know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. But the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Here we see clearly that this woman was just religious, but he had not encountered the living waters. Do you know that there are people in today's church, they have not encountered Jesus Christ? They are just being religious. You are listening to me. Have you encountered Jesus Christ afresh? Are you not just religious? You were born in a church and you feel that you just continue in that church like that. Have you encountered God personally? Have you met Jesus Christ personally? This woman had to meet Jesus Christ personally so that they can break the yoke of religion and they can break the yoke of tradition. He met Jesus Christ personally in our own life. Have you met Jesus personally? family, or you are still continuing in the religious tradition of your fathers? Are you continuing in that religious knowledge that this is the way we are doing it in this church? This is our family church. This is our generation church. This is how we do it. This is nothing but religion. God is a spirit, and those that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Today's believers are serving God in ignorance. They are ignorant about the grace of God. They don't know that salvation is by grace and not by works. Holiness is by grace and not by works. Heaven is not by merit, not by religion, not by moral righteousness, but is by the grace of God. This was the same problem of the Pharisees. They were self-righteous and they were justifying themselves. They will not allow the grace of God to enter into their heart. They will not allow the grace of God to transform their life. They remain ignorant about the things of God. They were serving God in ignorance. Truly, they were going about preaching, but they have not encountered Jesus Christ personally. They don't know him, and so they are establishing self-righteousness all over. They will tell you, don't wear this, don't put on this, so that you can be saved. They will not tell you that you need to accept Jesus onto your life. You need to know that Jesus Christ saved you by grace and not by works. And so there's need for repentance, and there's need for total turning away from all sin and be converted. Don't preach religion to people. Don't tell people to be religious. God is not a God of religion. God is the God of grace, and he's not calling anyone to religion. He is calling you to repentance and following him, but not by the same religious understanding that you have. In the book of Luke chapter 18 from verse 9, see what it says. Two men went up to the mountain to pray, the one a Pharisee, the one a publican. The Pharisee stood and prayed thus with himself, "Sir, God, I thank thee." Imagine. See the way he spoke. "God, I thank thee." That's the same character of the Pharisee of today's church, who believe that they are righteous more than other people. They believe because they are attending a so and so church, they are righteous more than other people. They are serving God more than other people. Look at the way he approached God. No humility. See pride. And this category of people will still say that they are serving God. That is what is happening in today's churches. They are proud and arrogant. They don't have the true humility and the brokenness of Jesus Christ. They are just religious. What they are after is that they don't wear this, they don't do this, and they think that, they feel that if they are observing all this thing, that means that they are righteous. He said that, "God, I thank thee that I'm not as other men are, extortioners, unjust adulterers. I fast twice in the week." Can you see? "I give tithe of all that I possess." Can you see? He said he's fasting twice in a week. Fasting does not make you righteous. All these are just religious activities. Have you been converted? He said that, "I give tithe of all that I possess." Can you see? And the publican standing above will not lift up so much his eyes unto heaven. He smote himself and said, "Be merciful unto me, a sinner." It is only those who see their sins and see that they are not righteous and see that they are sinners that need God's mercy. They are the only one that can what? That can receive God's grace. Only those people that will see themselves and humble themselves that I'm just being religious here. I have not received this righteousness of God. I have not encountered Jesus Christ. They are the only one that what will be justified by God. Serving God in ignorance is the logo of today's generation. Serving God, when you are not serving God under the Holy Spirit, you are serving God in ignorance. When you are not serving God with a mindset of grace, you are serving God in ignorance. When you are serving God with the understanding that if you don't do this, you are not saved, you are serving God in ignorance. If you are like the woman at the well, who is just following the religion of his fathers, you are serving God in ignorance. You need to understand God and encounter him afresh. Cornelius had to be sent to Peter. If you read that place, Acts chapter 10, you will see that he later encountered God afresh. He discovered that he had been religious. He had been just been self-righteous until God delivered him and break the yoke of religion in his life. You need to encounter God. Stop serving God in ignorance. God is not asking for your money when you have not released your soul. God is not asking for anything from you when you have not released your soul. Stop all your activities in the church. Stop all your religious activities in the church when you are still living in sin. Stop your running around for your pastor when you have not encountered God. If you are in that church and you know that you have not encountered God, get out of that church now.
so that you will not rot in hell. You need to come out of religion, come out of ignorance, serve God in spirit, serve God with a mindset of grace, serve God with proper understanding, serve God and have a personal encounter with the Holy Spirit, serve God and have a personal relationship with the Holy Spirit, serve God with understanding with the mindset of grace, serve God and enter into the covenant of intimacy with the Father, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, serve God and let God know that you are his son. God said that, he said every that he know his own, he said let everyone that never the name of Christ, let them depart from iniquity. You need to cry where you are and God say, God deliver me from ignorance, deliver me from self-righteousness, deliver me from self-justification, then save me by your grace. I am tired of my own self, save me by your grace, write my name in the book of life, let your grace deliver me from every sin, let your grace cleanse every sin. I see myself as a sinner, deliver me from every self-righteousness, help me to know you more, help me to understand you more. Pray where you are, beloved, pray where you are, pray and ask God to give you this grace. In Jesus mighty name we pray. I pray that God will help you to draw close to him and move out of religion in the name of Jesus. May the eyes of your understanding be enlightened to understand what Jesus Christ has done, and you may you cease from your religious activities and come into grace in the name of Jesus. In Jesus mighty name we are praying. Thank you for joining us in today's podcast. My name is Olakunle, beloved Jesus Christ. We will meet again same time, same station next week on the Living Waters. Thank you.
I'm not blind, come and drink from this fountain. I'm not dull, because anyone that